So we're going to continue with glycogen metabolism, other pathways and other minor carbohydrates which are fructose and galactose metabolism. Glycogen is a storage form of glucose which can be easily mobilized for energy. So what happens is you might recognize this as a step in the glycolysis process. The starting step, which is glucose 6-phosphate, is the starting substrate for glycogen synthesis. What you need to know is it is suppose this is a molecule of glucose, okay? You're going to add more molecules of glucose like this. That is going to happen along the 1,4 linkage, which is the 1,4 glycosidic linkage is going to be like this, and there's going to be a lot of cross linking happening. So you're going to end up with a structure like something like a net. So this is glycogen. Glycogen is stored in various parts of the body. Mainly it can be seen in muscles, liver and certain other areas, and it can be retrieved easily for energy. The cycle is pretty simple. You don't need to know all the enzymes specific name. You need to know that there's a link between galactose and glucose, where there's a something called UDP glucose, which will come in galactose metabolism. It's an interlink between galactose and glucose, and you need to know that there's some enzyme called glycogen synthase. So if you want a simple cycle or so, I will show it to you in the overview, but this is the whole cycle per se of glycogen. What's more important is glycogen storage diseases. These diseases are named, so there are six of them. They are von Gerke, Pompe, Corys, Anderson, McArdle, Hirst. You need to know the enzymes which are being deficient in each of these conditions. First one is glucose 6-phosphatase. Do not confuse this with glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase, okay? That comes in HMP pathway, which you are going to cover next. So that's a small thing over there. A small mnemonic here would be the first two you need to remember it somehow, but the next two you can remember it with the small trick which I use, A, B, C, D. So Anderson's disease is going to have a deficiency in branching enzyme, Corey's disease in debranching enzymes, okay? And then for the fifth and sixth, it's M for M and H for H. Muscle for McArdle and hepatic for Hirst disease. So that would be enough about glycogen storage disease. Moving on to hexose monophosphorylation pathway, this is basically a link between glucose and nucleotide synthesis. So what's going to be formed is ribulose, or more so ribose. You know about ribose, deoxyribose, all those things are part of the nucleotide. So it's going to help in ribose formation, which is a 5-carbon compound. Okay, that is the first thing you need to know about HMP pathway. Second thing is there is NADPH formation. NADPH and NADH are two different entities. They are not to be confused. NADPH has specific roles in our body. Few of them are fatty acid synthesis, cholesterol synthesis, steroid synthesis, antioxidant property. Of all of these, this antioxidant property is to be noted, because it's very helpful. Like anywhere the respiration, cellular respiration takes place, a lot of oxygen free radicals are going to be formed. Oxygen free radicals in the sense hydrogen peroxide and superoxides, all those are harmful, okay? So NADPH is going to help in dealing with these harmful chemicals produced within our body. There's a another component to it, which is called glutathione peroxidase, which actually does the neutralization of all these harmful things. NADPH gives energy to that glutathione to make sure it relieves all the chemical properties out of the cells. So next, you need to know about glucose 6-phosphate deficiency disease. This is a very, very important disease, and it's going to keep coming back next year as your pathology and all. So it involves the first step of HMP pathway. A small thing more about HMP pathway is split into two two paths. Okay, one is reversible oxidation and one is irreversible oxidation. So this whole part, that is irreversible oxidation part. From here, from ribulose, you can go back to glucose. You can go back to glucose through glycolysis intermediate. And that is a two-way process. There are certain sugars like ribulose, xylulose, and sadoheptulose, which are involved. They are all reversible processes. Basically, they are going to be helpful in nucleotide synthesis. But this NADPH formation is irreversible, and you need to know that about hexose monophosphate shunt pathway. Moving on to fructose and galactose, this is going to be very short. I'll be just touching upon where they go and join in the glucose metabolism, because ultimately they're going to pop up somewhere in glycolysis, or mostly glycolysis, and that's it. So fructose, it's taken in from the diet, and the first step is fructose 1,6-phosphate. You add a phosphate to it so that it's trapped within the cell. And the enzyme which is going to do this is fructokinase. Deficiency of this enzyme is going to cause essential fructosuria, which means there is fructose is not going to stay within any cell, and it's going to be excreted by the urine. Very fatal condition and very damaging to the kidneys. So please note that. And second thing is aldolase B. Deficiency in aldolase B is going to cause hereditary fructose intolerance. So what this fructose intolerance is going to do is there's going to be accumulation of fructose 1-phosphate, and fructose 1-phosphate is going to cause problems for us by transforming into other forms. Okay, mostly the link between fructose and glucose is this compound called sorbitol, which causes very notorious and causes a lot of problems. So you need to know about that. We'll talk about more about this in detail later. And you see this glyceraldehyde over here, you just add a phosphate to it, it becomes G3P, which is a glycolysis intermediate. So to be noted, you can just put this as a branch of glycolysis or something. And then moving on to galactose. Galactose is very simple, same thing, goes to galactose 1-phosphate and then goes into glycogen metabolism. You see this UDP glucose over here, I'll show you the same thing in glycogen metabolism right here. So here it is. So UDP glucose and UDP galactose are interchangeable. UDP glucose and UDP galactose are interchangeable, and there are two deficiencies which you know, which you should know. One is galactokinase deficiency, same thing as fructokinase deficiency. There's not going to be any galactose within your body. And then galactosemia, which is accumulation of galactose in blood in the form of galactose 1-phosphate, and there's going to be accumulation of galactitol. I'm not sure about the spelling, please check it out, but that's going to cause a lot of problems, same like sorbitol. So that's it for this video, guys. Thank you.